What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another day in the Car Mechanic Simulator with me, the virtual mechanic, and today's project, the lovely Nissan Skyline R31, modded in by Fulysic. Still don't know how to say your name. I do apologize if I've butchered it, but what a wonderful car. Very much looking forward to getting stuck into this one. Doesn't have the biggest engine in the game at all. It still has a very nice engine. It's an i4 double overhead cam SR20DET. Be the last time I say that engine in the game. I did get it from auction and I did just about get a good price for it. It wasn't ripped off too badly. This is quite nice. I've been looking forward to getting stuck into this one for a little while, mostly because there is a lot to do with it. If I just jump in and show you in here, lots of different engine covers, lots of different front bumpers, front ends, doors, wings, bonnets, hoods, whatever you want to call them, trunk lids, lights. There's a lot of options to go through, so I'm going to have a lot of fun working out how I want this one to look today. Probably nothing original will stay in this car. I probably will just scrap all the body panels to take off of it and start afresh. We are also going to pit performance parts in this engine today, squeeze as much power as we can from it just to see what comes standard from it and how good we can make this. So let's get stuck in. You can see there's a lot of dust on here. Let's get it over to the car wash. Let's get this one cleaned up. Here we are then at the car wash. Right-hand drive, Japanese import, I'm assuming, but let's get it cleaned up. We can already see that it's mostly a purpley colour. Looking pretty tasty. I don't want to repair any of these body panels anyway, or that door is pretty good, but I'm just going to scrap all of them and start afresh on the body. So let's get the interior done. Let's get it back on the lift. And let's get that engine ripped out. Probably be keeping these seats, although I won't be keeping that. I will be replacing them with these seats because they look pretty good. So let's get it back on the lift and let's get the engine ripped out. The oil pan is connected, so let's get the oil drained first before we start stripping the exhaust and the drive shaft and stuff. At least we know it's done. Not too much in there. Let's get you put away and then let's have a look. I first of all want to get this drive shaft off, so I'm going to crack on with this. Hopefully it comes out nice and simple. And then I just want to make sure I can get that gearbox out. So let's take off that and the starter. And then hopefully this gearbox will come out and the engine will just lift straight out after this. Fingers crossed that came out nice and easy. Let's get it back on the ground and grab the crane. And rip that engine out, hopefully in one go. Yes, that means I did everything right. That's good. Let's have a look what we've got going on here. Let's have a look at this engine bay. Not too much in there. There are some liquids, so I'm going to start by draining them wonderful liquids. Out you come. All of the reservoirs are cleaned out now. There was one hiding back here. You almost couldn't see it from over this side. I nearly missed it. I was up here. Could just see it at the bottom there. So let's start getting all of this stripped out. Obviously, we've got the modules here. I will come back. I haven't even seen the fuse box yet, so let's have a look and make sure there is a fuse box. Is that it? That's it. Two fuse boxes actually on this one. Nice battery for us to repair. Let's get the lids off of these. And I'm going to finish stripping the rest of this off, get these fuse boxes out, and then I will see you guys in a couple of minutes because we're going to get this suspension off next. We're going to have a look what we've got going on down there, although we can see most of it from here. Double wishbone shock at the front. So anyway, let's get the rest of this out and then I'll meet you underneath when we get that suspension gone. Let's jump under and have a look at this suspension then. Let's start by getting this front wheel off. Couple of rusty bolts on there. Let's have a look. It is a double wishbone. We have got the cross member on here, which is something that can be painted, which I like. Double wishbone with a nice shock. Oh, there's another fuse box there. I missed that one. Didn't see you hiding up there. Anyway, and then the rear end does look like it's got a lot missing, but it is my favourite one with all of the rubber bushings everywhere, but there is quite a few parts missing, so I'm going to have to come back and sort this out. So I'm going to start stripping this down, and then I'm going to go back and get that fuse box, and then we will get the engine stripped before we come out and do the body and the welding. I'll see you in a little while. Just got the body, frame, and interior to do on this Nissan Skyline. But next up, we need to get... Oh, run into that pillar. We need to get the engine dismantled. We know we got a battery, so let's throw that on. And let's start stripping this i4 double overhead cam engine and see what we've got going on here. Let's start with the big fan at the front, because you can't go wrong with that. Let's get some of these belts off. And then let's just jump straight into the top if we can and try and see what's going on underneath this head cover. Probably two camshafts, I imagine, but I'm not always right about the internals of these engines. So let's jump in and have a look. Did I miss a screw? Yes, I did. Couldn't see it there. Out you come. And then on the other side, lovely big turbocharger. Looking forward to that one. That should have a wonderful turbo whistle on it a bit later on. Lots of rusty bolts on this one. Probably a bit too far gone, but all I want to do is get this engine head off and have a look what's underneath. Make sure we're not messing. Oh, what am I missing now? Ignition coils. God, anyone would think this wasn't episode number 60, wouldn't they? Come on, off you come. Let's have a look what we've got then. Nice. Good old timing chain with a couple of gears holding in there and then camshaft caps on top of that. So now I want to get down underneath, so I'm going to crack on and get a little bit more of this off. I join you back here in just a minute. Definitely getting a very near the end now. Let's just get this oil filter out. Let's get the timing shoe off, if I could say it. Don't know what happened there. Then hopefully, yes, the chain, then the gears, and then that should pretty much be it. Straight into that. Get the spark plugs out, rip the head off, and then get the pistons out. And we will be done. So I'm going to leave that here, and then I'll meet you back at the car in just a moment when we'll get that body and frame all sorted out. See you there in a second. Everything stripped now apart from the body on the Nissan Skyline. So let's just jump in. That's quite a big piece. I like that. Let's get all of this taken off. I don't think there's too much on here. So I'm just going to try and run around and grab all of this in one go if I can. I think that's all of it. Let's have a quick double check around very quickly. Doesn't appear to be anything else. Just got to get that interior seat out. That was weird. Hello? There we go. Get that interior seat out, which it really doesn't want to let me grab. There we go. No. There we go. That was bizarre. It really, really wanted me to be in a fixed place for that. That is all the body sorted. Let's just have a check on here. 1%. That looks to be sorted, but let's get this frame all sorted out now. Then I'm going to head over to the shop and buy lots of body panels. 200, very cheap. That's what I like to see. Going to go and buy every single body panel and see what kind of configuration I like on this car. So I'll see you back here in a couple of moments when I've got hopefully everything together and we're ready to go over to the paint shop. I'll see you then. Here she is then, body all back together. I went for some flared wings front and back. There are two options for the flares at the back. You can have them with a little plastic strip that runs down there. I decided not to go with that one. I went for this big triple layered wing, looking pretty nice. Obviously, R31 virtual mechanic plates. These lights, I believe, are paintable, but I may come back and change them later, depending on how that works out, because I'm not 100%. And a big old tin can exhaust. Slightly angled to the side, absolutely fantastic, with a bigger bumper at the back and this lovely tow hook bumper at the front. Looks absolutely stunning. These are paintable, definitely. And obviously, you got the roll cage on the inside there. I wanted it with the back seats in because I wanted it to be semi-practical, but I may change that because I don't think you can get there. So I may just quickly swap that one out to one without the back seats. We'll jump back in a minute. I've got to grab the interior. Then we're going to head over to the paint shop and pick what color we're going to have for this lovely R31 Skyline. What would you pick? Let me know in the comments down below. I'll see you in just a moment. Here's what I went for then. I know some of you are going to say bloody virtual mechanic and his red and black combos again. But I really like this. This is a metallic red and a metallic black dotted around. Now, I know I really wanted these paintable, and then I've gone and painted them black anyway. They are in the metallic black to match the front bumper there, looking pretty tasty. Then I've got the rear arch in the metallic black, which obviously does connect to that window, but it doesn't paint the window. And the rear bumper in metallic black, along with the rear light surrounds in a metallic black as well. Really like how this is turning out. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the wheels yet. I might do a red one at the back and a black one at the front, or I might do them all black, or I might just leave them chrome to sort of match the ends of this and the exhaust on there. Not 100%. Again, not 100% with the suspension either. Probably just going to black a load of it out. But one thing I do like with this is the engine cover that's built in actually colors to match the car. So now the car's engine is black and red, and I really, really love that. I think it looks absolutely incredible. Let's get it back on the lift. Let's get some suspension painted and then back on the car and see how good it looks. I'll see you over there in just a couple of moments. Everything's painted and ready to go back on the car. Let's have a look at these metallic red shocks with metallic black springs. They look really smart on there. Hopefully all of the other metallic paints are matching, apart from obviously the brake calipers. I hate the brake calipers. They are in red though. Hopefully they come out looking half decent. Let's just crack on and let's see where we get to. A lot of black, a lot of red in this. In fact, it is all black and red. So let's get it on. Let's start with the lower arms. Looking quite nice in the black there. This is all just black on red on black on red. Hopefully it comes out looking amazing. We will see. Let's get this shock on. That's looking pretty tasty. I like that. Let's get to the brake caliper and then see how everything looks together. Hopefully it looks all right. And then we'll move on to the back end because that's got a lot more on it, so a lot more to be painted. Hopefully that also comes out looking all right. Let's see. Let's just get to this brake caliper. Here we go. That's not the same red. Let's just get rid of that wheel. That's not the same red by any stretch of the imagination, but it is still looking pretty tasty. I'll get the rest of this front finished and then we'll move on to the back. I'll meet you down there in just a few moments. Let's have a look what we've got going on this back end section then. Hopefully this comes out looking amazing. Lots of red, lots of black. Lot of red there. Let's get into some of the black stuff. Hopefully, as I say, I really hope this comes out looking great. It is just a black and red combo, but you should all know by now that is one of my favorite color combinations. I think it goes really well together. And this metallic red is actually really nice. I'm really happy with how it came out. Let's just get towards the end of this and see how it looks because I want to get this spring and stuff on. So let's speed this up as much as we can by fixing up bolts and me just talking absolute nonsense while this is happening. Lovely red spring cap, lovely black spring. This is looking quite nice. I'm very happy with this. I won't bother going all the way to the brake caliper because you've already seen it. So I'm just going to get this finished and then we'll get the engine bay done next. I'll meet you up there in just a couple of minutes. See you soon. Underside all finished, looking fantastic in this black and red combo. Absolutely amazing. But we have got to get this engine bay sorted. I have painted a few of the bits in here very pointlessly because they are all hidden under covers. They are in a metallic black, looking quite tasty. Got to remember to get this fuse box as well, also in a metallic black. Very pointless because none of that can be seen, same as a lot of the other stuff. Can't forget the ECU hidden down there in the corner, little blinder. So let's crack on. Let's get some of this finished. I have got the air filter to go in there and the air filter clips. The filter base itself is in a metallic black and then the clips are in a metallic red. Again, just did it because that's how I do things. Absolutely pointless because I will show you in just a few moments why you can't see any of this. Still got some more clips to go on that. Let's get the radiator on and the radiator housing fan on. There we go. And the battery, which I have remembered to pick up for a change, which is very unlike me. I'm going to go on and get the rest of this all finished, get the clips all on and get the fuse boxes all filled up. Then I'll show you where everything's hidden. And then we're going to go and build that beautiful engine that I have painted again, pointlessly because it sits under that cover, but mostly just in a black, just to black it all out. So I'll see you in just a few moments when I've got all of this finished. See you soon. I think that is everything done in the engine bay. I'm not 100%. I can't see much more, but there is a lot going on in here. So let's just have a look. And now I'm going to show you why you can't see any of these bits that I've painted. Air filter sits nicely underneath the air filter. Magic. The fuse boxes sit underneath there. And the other fuse box itself is hidden in the dashboard. So you can't see it at all. So I did paint them. It was pointless. But that is all the engine bay sorted. All the suspension sorted. Wheels and engine to go. So let's go and pit back together that glorious, glorious engine. As I said, I did black most of it out just so it had a color on it. I don't really like working without the colors too much, but I'm going to crack on. I'm going to get most of this done. There's no point sticking around to the end for the color because you won't see the color on this engine. It is hidden by the engine cover. So I'm just going to get this one finished and then we'll get it back in the car ready to go outside. I'll see you shortly. There she is, all finished, looking amazing. I have sort of tried to match the colour of the engine cover in there. We'll see. I'm hoping none of it pops through. So let's go and find out. Let's get this bonnet open. You just saw the engine there. As you can see, similar but not exact, because my cover is red with deeper red writing on it, basically. Pretty much the only difference. So let's throw this in and see if it makes a difference. Hopefully that engine cover, the one time I really want an engine cover to be on there and be right. And that looks absolutely amazing. It hasn't changed it at all. Brilliant. But obviously we do know that engine has been changed and swapped in because it is hiding in there. I'm going to get the exhaust and the gearbox finished. Then we'll get some wheels picked for this lovely car. And then we'll be outside all finished, ready to have a look at this one. I'll see you outside in just a little while. Here we are then, all finished with the R31 Skyline. Looking absolutely incredible. For the rims, I just stuck pretty much with what was on it. I have changed it ever so slightly. These are the Nissan 370Z rims, so you do need the Nissan DLC if you're going to use this one. They're 225 width with a 30 profile. Now, the only difference I've changed on there is I've painted the tips red because these are two-toned rims. I love how these turned out. They look amazing. And I've taken a little bit off the profile. They're supposed to be a 40 profile. I've left them as a 30. I tried fiddling around with these. I played around with so many different wheel sizes and configurations, but sadly, I just have run out of time. So I just had to go with pretty much what was standard with my own little spin on it. Still looks pretty great. I'm very happy with how it looked. I wanted to bring them out a bit further to the edge of this, maybe make them a bit smaller, look like they were properly in it, but I just couldn't get it done. It was taking too long already. I'd already spent about an hour just doing the rims and I needed to get on because I'm away this weekend. So I need to try and make loads of videos to get everything filled up in there. So I did just leave them as they were. They do look great though. And this engine cover and engine bay, I personally think looks absolutely amazing. Is the only time I've been happy with an engine cover because it pretty much covers up my engine, but it looks absolutely fantastic. This is a beautiful car. I do like the big wing on the back. I do like the blacks and reds all mixed in. I think it looks absolutely amazing. Very well done to Fulysic. And if you are on Steam, you are playing this on PC, get over to the Steam Workshop, download this one for yourself, have a play around with it, have some fun. There are lots of options, lots of different ways of doing it. And don't forget, you can always send me what you've done on Instagram so I can have a look. Either hashtag it virtual mechanic, that's something I check all the time, or send it to me direct for an instant message. I'll get to look at it and I'll let you know what I think. Let's jump in this one though and see what it sounds like. If I could get in there, because that rear window likes to cover things. So let's get this one started up. Very, very spaceship sound there. Let's give it some revs. Absolutely love that turbo whistle. Sounds amazing. Let's get it on the dyno and see what horsepower it's got. Here we are then on the dyno with the R31 Skyline Track Edition. 225 starting horsepower. How much have we managed to add to it? Let's find out. Only an additional 112 horsepower, exactly 50%. Hitting us up to 337. I was expecting a little higher, but let's get it onto the track and see what speed it can do. Here we are then on the track with the R31 Skyline. Let's see what speed we can get. Let's go. Bit slow off acceleration there, but then it hits going. That's pretty good. Coming up towards 200 kilometers an hour now. There it is. What are we going to get to with the top speed on this lovely R31 Skyline? Hoping to beat 350, but it's not looking very likely right now. Come on, car, you can do it. There's 300. Can we get up to 350? No, probably not. Come on, 325. 324. Very close. Still pretty good, though. So here we are then for the final time with the R31 Skyline by Fulysic. Absolutely stunning. I love this model. Very, very well done. I love all the different customization options you can play around with. Unfortunately, it does mean that I did spend a lot more money today than I wanted to, which we will go into in just a few moments. But 324 kilometers an hour, does pin it 47th in our leaderboard, which is not a good shout at all. So I think if we do this one again, we're going to change the config, swap that engine to something better, maybe remove the engine cover so we can pin our own stuff in there. Don't know. We will see if we come to do another one of these, but not the best top speed. But it does look absolutely stunning. I do love how this car looks, how it sounds, and to be fair, how it drives. It does drive very well. It's just not the quickest. Now, that could be partly to do with my gearbox setup, partly to do with the inline four engine. Could be a lot of things, but let's go to some facts and figures. Now, as you saw at the beginning of this episode, I spent $8,638 buying the car, but sadly, I have spent $53,202 today modifying and upgrading this car, putting our total spend at $61,840. But it's all about what we can sell this car for. So let's jump in and have a look. 247,000 kilometers an hour car. Obviously, our wheels are slightly different to them sizes there. 337 kilometers an hour, horsepower, should I say. It's 324 kilometers an hour with our engine tuning upgrades there today. But how much can we sell it for? No. $50,078. That pits us at a loss of $11,762. Now, that is probably all my fault because I bought all of the engine covers to see which one I liked. Then I bought all of the bonnets to see which one I like. I bought a couple of bumpers and then I sold them all off. So obviously I took a massive hit on them anyway. So it is my own fault. Probably shouldn't sell this car because it is for a loss. But I am going to sell this one because we will hopefully do another one that I may keep later on. So goodbye, R31 Skyline. You were a lot of fun, but you cost me $11,500. Up next, though, we've got the Delahaye. This is a replica Delahaye. I think that's how you pronounce it, Delahaye. Yeah, it sounds about right. This is also modded in by Fulysic. So two in a row for him today. Good work. Well, not today, but you know what I mean. This is going to be a lot of fun. I haven't played with one of these yet. I love everything about this. The doors open backwards that you can't see on here, obviously. Suicide doors, lots of covers over everything. Barely even see the wheels. This is going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to have a lot of joy doing this one. And also modifying that absolutely monster of an engine that is huge. I can't wait to get stuck into that one. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you did enjoy today's video. Consider leaving a comment and let me know what you think below. Maybe even like it. And if you really want to push the boat out, consider clicking that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.